Hello students, welcome to the session. So in the previous session in semiconductor physics, we have seen the common base configuration of a transistor. So let us see that. So common base configuration. So different configurations, and that we have seen the common base configuration, and in that we have defined current gain, that is alpha, voltage gain and power gain, all those things. Even we have studied input characteristics and output characteristics, and we have drawn the curves, how they look like. Okay, fine. So these are those things. So we have studied what is known as an Early effect. So input resistance, output resistance, current gain, voltage gain and power gain. Okay. Yeah. So and one more point to be need to remember here. What is that point to be remembered here? You need to remember a point. You can keep in a note. The output voltage signal is in phase with the input voltage signal. Since as we are studying that is an amplification. So this is the transistor device. I am sending the input signal will be like this. Then I will get the output signal here. That obviously enhanced. There is a voltage gain. This is the input voltage signal. And this will be the output, and here is the transistor that is in common base configuration, but both are in the same phase. So the output voltage signal, you can call the output signal, the output voltage signal is in phase with the input voltage signal. So the phase difference between them is 0. Phase difference between them will be 0 degrees. Okay. So now let us see the common emitter configuration. So in this class, we will see the common emitter configuration. Common emitter configuration. Okay, so let us see this common emitter configuration. Okay, so common emitter configuration. Emitter will be common here. For both input as well as output, emitter will be common. Just like we have explained in the previous session, it also follows like that one. Emitter will be common. So once emitter will be common, then what will be the input terminal? Base will be the input terminal. Then what will be the output terminal? Collector is the output terminal. Okay. So remember here these factors. So then how the situation will look like? So for an NPN transistor, let's say I am making this is the E means emitter, that is common for input as well as output. So this will be the input part here. This will be the output part here. Remember, input will be the forward biased, then output will be the reverse biased here. That is emitter base junction will be a forward biased and collector junction will be the reverse biased. So as it is reverse bias, N is connected to the positive. As this is forward bias, N is connected to the negative. N is connected to the negative. Okay. So N is connected to the negative or P is connected to the positive, both are same. So this is I am making as a grounding. So this is the configuration. Okay. So now we study the input characteristics and output characteristics. So input characteristics, that means input, it is base current, base emitter voltage. So we need to study the how base current changes when base emitter voltage is either increased or decreased. Okay, so by keeping in view that we need to keep the output will be constant, then what will be the output for it? So collector emitter voltage constant, VCE kept constant. VCE kept constant. So the graphs will look like this. So base current, base emitter voltage. Obviously forward bias, remember, it will be a forward bias. We are keeping the VCE is of constant. Common emitter. So collector voltage, that is output voltage, we are keeping constant. First step at 0, then as I increases, then the graph will be looks like this. Okay, fine. So now what happens in the input characteristics? Yeah, I'm sorry, this is the input characteristics. Let's go for the output characteristics. So in output characteristics means collector current, voltage. We need to plot the graph of IC versus VCE, keeping IB constant. Input will be constant, that is base will be constant, base current will be constant. So we are studying the output characteristic, keeping the input characteristics will be constant. Okay, fine. So let's see here. So that is a collector current, collector emitter voltage. So we are keeping the base current will be at 0, then making the 20, making the 40, then the graphs will be loops like this. Okay, fine. So now let us define some of the important factors here. That is, one is the resistance, that you know already, input resistance, dynamic resistance. Input means V equal to IR, that is base emitter voltage divided by base current. That is, obviously we need to keep the output will be constant. Okay, so output resistance. In output, collector is there, collector current is there, but input will be keeping constant. Okay. That important factor we need to define is the current gain. The current gain beta factor. So the current gain beta we have defined, it is output by input. In the output, current will be the collector current. In the input, base current. That is output by input. Obviously, I is large, IC is moderate, medium value or intermediate value, IB is small. So when I am comparing these two, obviously IC is greater than that of IB. So that ratio will be greater than, so beta will be greater than 1. That is important for me. So what is the generally the values of beta? So what is the generally the values of beta? The values of beta. So alpha values will be something like 0.1234562 0.98 0.99, something like this. So then what is the value of beta? So the values of beta will be large values, and they will have a values up to 100 like this. So beta will be varies from 15 to 50. So generally they'll provide 15 less than beta less than 50, even sometimes 70 also 700, but practically it will be of 15 to 15 to 50. So Now, if we define what is the voltage gain, what is the power gain, then we can compare with this common base configuration. Remember, again is the values of alpha. The values of alpha is very small, like 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, something like this, up to 0.999, that is 1. So, the values of alpha generally, so they are of something like 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. Something lags, they'll go up to the 1, that is 0.99, that is 98, like this. Okay, so the last value is a 1. Okay, so now define here, what is the current gain? Define here, that is the current gain. That is already defined, beta, that we have defined for the output, that is delta IC by, that we have defined already for this, delta IC by delta IB. Then define voltage gain. Then define voltage gain, give the symbol AV. Voltage gain. So that is voltage gain will be is equal to output by input. That is output voltage by input voltage. Output for us will be collector. So that is voltage means V is equal to IR, that is collector current multiplied by output resistance. Input will be base. Okay. But delta IC by delta IB we defined as beta. That is R output by R input. Okay, this is the voltage gain. Let's define for the power gain. Let's define for the power gain. So put AP. So this is simply power gain is voltage gain multiplied by current gain. Voltage gain multiplied by current gain. So, voltage gain multiplied by current gain is the beta. So, power gain is, that is beta into beta, beta square, RO divided by RI. So, remember here the factor beta square is coming. The beta square is very large. So, beta is approximately, say for example, 20, you are making 20 square, that is it will become 400. So, the power gain in common emitter is extremely large compared to that of the common base. So that means that's why we use it as an amplifier here. So amplifier circuit ga manam vaadtam, transistor will be used as a amplifier here. So that means there is a transistor will be in the common emitter configuration. Transistor in the common emitter configuration, there is an input signal, its input sinusoidal signal, it has the input voltage we call as, then there will be output voltage, then of course it is phase dipped by 180 degrees, this phase dipped by 180 degrees, that is enhanced. It is one enhanced, that is the output, much greater than that of the input. So even input power is PI, output power is PO, that is much greater than that of the input power. Okay, so even you notice here, the output voltage is a phase difference of 180 degrees. That note point important here, the output voltage signal is 180 degrees out of phase with the input signal. So, and one more point you need to remember here. Power gain in common emitter amplifier is extremely large compared to that of common base amplifier. So, power gain in common emitter is very much greater than that of power gain in the common base amplifier. So, previous ga mana discuss chesinatvanti common emit base lo nu ippudu discuss chesinatvanti common emitter lo compare chesthe the gain will be large in common emitter. That's why transistor will be used as an amplifier in common emitter configuration. It will be used as an amplifier in common emitter configuration. We'll see some problems, then you'll understand. So remember this one. There is one important quantity to define: transconductance. In common emitter mode, there is one more term I'll define here. That is transconductance. The transconductance. Another definition I want to give here, that is the transconductance. Transconductance. The symbol I'll give as GM is a transconductance. The transconductance. So it is defined as the ratio of change in collector current to base emitter voltage by keeping the emitter voltage constant. Collector emitter voltage will be constant. That means the ratio is defined as transconductance. The conductance will be, that is, resistance is defined as V by I. Conductance generally defined as I by V. That from elementary circuit analysis you might know in these terms. That is, change in the collector current divided by change in the base emitter. Okay, keeping collector emitter is at constant. Okay, so even this we can represent in terms of beta. So how we define the beta will be here. So beta delta IC by delta IB. Beta is equal to delta IC by delta IB. Let us substitute in place of delta IC. That is, GM will be is equal to beta into delta IB divided by delta VB. So, but what are the input resistance will be? So, delta VBE divided by delta IB. Input voltage by input current. So from here, what I conclude, GM will be is equal to beta divided by input resistance of the circuit. That is the transconductance. Okay, fine. So this is a common emitter configuration, that is important for us. This common emitter configuration we use most of the amplifier cases. Which one we use, either common base or common emitter or common collector? We use only common emitter for a signal enhancement. That is, if you want to increase the output power, we use the transistor as an amplifier in the CE configuration. That's what actually this is the theory related to this. Okay, fine. So let us move to the next last one, that is a common collector configuration. That is a common collector configuration. Yeah, fine. So common collector configuration. Collector will be common here. Okay. So clearly, base terminal of the transistor serves as an input, emitter serves as the output. So that means we have emitter, base, collector. That means common collector. Make, this will be the common. This will make as a grounding process. It is make grounding, zero potential, common for us. Now, base serves as the input. Give the input. Emitter serves as the output. Emitter serves as the output. Okay. So, now as usual, input characteristics. Let's say this is the NPN transistor. Collector will be common here. Collector will be common here. Now you remember this junction, emitter base junction will be of forward biased. Collector, this junction will be of reverse bias. So NPN transistor connected to negative, that is forward biased. P is connected to positive. This is N is connected to negative, that is a reverse biased. Okay, fine. So this junction will be the reverse bias and this junction will be a forward bias. That is what actually we require. So this is the NPN transistor. Yeah, we study the input characteristics. So when we study the input characteristics, what to do? Relationship between the input current, that is base current, and input voltage, that is base collector, as collector is common. Base collector, this is the characteristics. So we need to keep the output will be constant. Output means collector. So taken along the characteristics, so determine the output voltage is kept constant. Output voltage will be kept constant. That is, output will be collector common. That will be the kept constant. So, collector emitter. Sorry. Collector emitter voltage will be kept constant. Emitter collector constant. So that's what actually the graphs. So input base current, base voltage. So by keeping the output will be emitter potential 3 volts, emitter potential 5 volts. So we are getting the graphs will be like this. Okay. So similarly, you go for the output characteristics. So when you are studying the output characteristics, so in the output who are present? The output emitter current and emitter collector. Emitter current, emitter current, base common collector voltage. We need to keep the input will be kept constant. What are the input will be here? So base, that is input will be the base current will be constant. Okay, so the graphs are shows like this. Keeping the input base current will be constant. We have studying emitter current versus emitter collector voltage. Then it will be looking like this. Okay. So just go through the self study. You can understand it. Then we'll define the transistor parameters. That is input resistance with output kept constant. Input resistance with output will be kept constant. Then output resistance like this. So one of the important factor is the current amplification factor, gamma. So output by input. So the gamma is also, that is output by input. Output by input. That is gamma is defined as output will be. What is the output will be? Emitter current. Input will be base current. Output by input. Okay, so this is what actually the lecture. Okay. So for us, mostly we require the common emitter configuration. The circuit will be used, that is common emitter configuration mode will be used as an amplifier. Okay. So let us solve some problems. Problems on transistor. So let's say the first problem I am quoting here. Find the relationship between alpha and beta. Find relation between alpha and beta of a transistor. Then what is the definition of alpha and what is the definition of beta? Then what is the relationship between them that is required? So immediately in your mind, first thing into the, so the, what is alpha? That is a common base configuration. So that is output is a collector current, input will be the emitter current. So and in beta, common emitter configuration, emitter is common. So what will be the input and output? Output will be the collector, input will be the base. Sorry, this is the base. Okay, now we need to find the relationship between them. We need to find the relationship between them. So what is the relation which connects between them? Using the current equation. What is the current equation in any transistor in any configuration? IE is equal to IB plus IC. Okay. From here you can write for IE. What is IE here? IC by alpha. From here you write for the IB. What is IB will be here? IC by beta. IE, that is IC by alpha, that is IB, IC by beta plus IC. We cancel everywhere IC. So 1 by alpha is equal to 1 by beta plus 1. So 1 by alpha is equal to 1 by beta plus 1. This is the relation between alpha and beta. Okay, fine. Remember this relation. So generally they will ask in the examination directly what is the relation between alpha and beta of a transistor. So let's go for the another problem. Let's say another problem will be as follows. The current gain of a transistor in a common base arrangement is, so common base arrangement, the current gain is alpha is given as 0.98. Find change in collector current corresponding to a change in emitter current. Change in emitter current 5 milliamperes. So we need to determine the change in collector current which is corresponding to this, and also what is the change in base current for this. So in a common base configuration, alpha they have given as 0.98 and the change in the emitter current is given as 5 milliamperes. If so, what is the change in collector current and base current? So immediately in your mind, the alpha definition will be is equal to, just now even previous case also given, common base. So output will be the collector current, input will be the emitter current. So from this what I'll get, delta IC will be is equal to alpha multiplied by delta IE. So from here delta IC will be, alpha is given in this as 0.98, delta IE is 5 milliamperes. So 5 into 0.98 approximately, so not 5, it is less than 5, 40, so 45, that is 4.9. 4.9 milliamperes. So that's done. Then what about IB? So using the current equation, what is the current equation will be? Delta IE is equal to delta IB plus delta IC. So delta IE is given as 5 milliamperes. Delta IB we don't know, but we have calculated delta IC as 4.9 milliamperes. So from this clearly base is equal to 0.1 milliamperes. Is 0.1 milliamperes. This is the problem. So, like very simple thing, just using the parameters, that is alpha, beta definitions and the power gain amplitude, that is a voltage gain formulas, these are enough to solve any problems here. Okay, fine. So, let's go to the another problem. So, that another problem will be like this. So, a transistor is connected to a common emitter configuration. Now, it is a common emitter configuration. So, the collector supply is 8 volt and voltage drop across the resistor of 800 in the collector circuit is 0.5 volt. If the current gain factor is 0.96, find the base current. Okay. So, the question will be, I'll write here, a transistor is connected in, common emitter configuration. The collector supply, is 8 volt. The collector supply will be is of 8 volt. The collector supply is of 8 volt and the voltage drop across a resistor of 800 ohms in the collector circuit is 0.5 volt. If the current gain factor is 0.96, find the base current. So, you read clearly, a transistor is connected in common emitter configuration, underline this point. Common emitter configuration. So, emitter is common. So, once emitter is common, what will be the input? Base will be the input. What will be the output? Collector will be the output. The collector supply. So, the collector supply is 8 volt. The collector supply is 8 volt. Okay. And the voltage drop across a resistor of 800 ohms in the collector circuit is 0.5 volts. That means collector means output. So there is a resistor of 800 ohms and there is a drop in the voltage is 0.5 volt. If the current gain is given 0.96, alpha is given and they are asking the base current. Okay. So we have this problem will be here, common emitter circuit. So, the solution will be simple here. So they are given in the common emitter configuration. In the common emitter configuration, what will be the input and what will be the output, that is important. So, common emitter, just now we have discussed. Input will be the base current, base emitter voltage, and output will be the collector current, V collector emitter. So output means collector circuit. Output means collector circuit. Input means base circuit. Base circuit. Okay. So this is what actually the common. We have common emitter circuit. Okay. If you want, you can draw the diagram also. Any one PNP transistor or NPN transistor, you will wish you can take any one thing. So, let us try, I am taking a transistor. So, there is a base, emitter, collector. बेस एमिटर एंड कलेक्टर, बेस एमिटर कलेक्टर. सो वी जनरली गिव द दिस इज कॉमन दैट इज इनपुट सिग्नल विल बी गिवन एट द लाइक दिस समवेयर विल गिव द इनपुट सिग्नल हियर दिस इज द इनपुट ओके देन बायसिंग पर्पस सो दिस इज द पीएनपी ट्रांसिस्टर दैट इज पीएनपी ट्रांसिस्टर फॉरवर्ड बायस एन इज कनेक्टेड टू द नेगेटिव एन इज कनेक्टेड टू द नेगेटिव This is common. This is VBE. So this is the input circuit is the base circuit. Now output circuit will be the collector circuit. Here is the load resistance, and this is the VCE. Generally we'll take the output will be here. Generally output will be taken here. Yeah, I'm sorry, this is VCC. This is the VCC. This is the VCC. So that is same as that of this is VCE. This entire thing will be VCE. This is VCE. Okay. Generally, they'll indicate like this. This is simply VCE. They'll indicate like this VCE. So that's why we write whatever be the potential drop across VCE, that is VCC minus ICRL. That is VCE is equal to VCC minus ICR load resistance and IC means current collector current. Okay, so now see here in this problem. So they have given is connected in the collector supply is of 8 volt. The collector supply is of 8 volt they have given. And the voltage drop across a resistor of 800 ohms in the collector circuit is 0.5 volt. That means that is important for me. Here they found that key RL is equal to 800 ohms. With voltage drop here it is, that is delta VL across this well is given as 0.5 volt. So with these two I can calculate the current flowing through it. So what is the current that will flow through it? That is the collector current will flow through it. That is the collector current will be flow through this. So this is the base current. And this will be the emitter current. This will be the collector current. The same collector current will flow through this. So I know the resistance. I know the potential drop. From that I can calculate what is so called the collector current. So then once I know the collector current, let's see here. So this is information. So first of all, what I can do here? I use the relationship between alpha and beta. That is 1 by alpha is equal to 1 by beta plus 1. So from here alpha is given as 0.96. That is equal to 1 by beta plus 1. From here I'll simplify 1 by 0.96 minus 1 will be is equal to 1 by beta. So this will become 1 minus 0.96 divided by 0.96, that is equal to 1 by beta. So from here if we cross multiply, beta will become 0.96 divided by 0.04. So 96 by 4 means 96, that is 24. Beta will be getting 24. We know already beta will lie in between 15 to 50. So once I get the beta, then what will be the definition of beta? The beta will be is equal to IC by, beta will be is equal to IC by IB. Beta I am getting as 24. Collector current, how to get the collector current? That's what here information already. Here from these three things the collector current can be calculated. The collector current can be calculated, that is delta VL is equal to IC into RL. This is 0.5. IC we don't know, RL will be 800. From here IC will be is equal to 0.5 by 800 amperes. That's what we got it. I got it. Let us substitute the same IC will be here. IC by AB. That is IC value is 0.85 divided by 800 and of course into IB. From here IB will be is equal to 0.5 divided by 800 into 24. So now you do one thing that can be written as IB will be is equal to, let us make here 500, that means multiply with 1000 and divide with 1000. Multiply with 1000 and divide with 1000. Then that will become 500 divided by 800 into 24 and of course into 1 by 1000. So that will become, instead of even 5000 you can keep here like this. Nothing wrong. Now I will put one more sum. So here it will be one more zero. So now this will be is of 50 by 80. So 50 divided by 8 into 24. That is 1 by 10,000. Better put in the micro, even better. So 4 zeros are there, 2 more zeros I add. Then 2 more zeros I add here. Then 2, 4, 6 will come. Then when I divide and add all these things, I will get 26 microamperes. IB will be the 26 microampere. That is the base current will be 26 microampere. Okay. This is what actually the, you just have to know idea what is the, they have given in the problem. What is the input they have given? What is the output they have? So in common emitter, input means base, output means collector. Then voltage drop across a load resistor will be is given, and he found that is 0.5, the resistor is 800 ohms. Then alpha is given, alpha means output current by input current. So not in common emitter case, that is a common base case. Then how to convert into common emitter case? That formula, that connecting formula I know. So once I know that formula, I can calculate what is the base current. Even emitter current also we can calculate. Okay, so this is what. Yeah. So go for another problem. Let us go for another problem. So in a common emitter amplifier, the load resistance of the output circuit, is 500 times the input resistance. Alpha is given, that is 0.98. then find, they are asking for us, find the voltage gain . Second one will be power gain. Voltage gain and the power gain. Okay, fine. In common emitter circuit they have given, just like in the previous case. Output resistance will be equal to 500 times that of the input resistance. Output is 500 times that of the input. That means output by input will be is of 500. That is the first question will be is equal to voltage gain. So that voltage gain, we know the direct formula, beta into R output by R input. But they have given in the problem only alpha, not beta. Then how to determine? The same formula. So that we have already, that is 1 by alpha is equal to 1 by beta plus 1. So from here 1 by alpha minus 1 will be is equal to 1 by beta. 1 minus alpha by alpha is equal to 1 by beta. So from here beta is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha. That is the formula we need to remember. Okay, so now beta value after substitution, what I'll get here, that is beta is equal to alpha value is given as 0.98 divided by 1 minus 0.98, that is 0.2, that is 98 divided by 2, 98 divided by 2, that will be is of 49. Okay, so that means AV will be is equal to, that is 49 multiplied by 500. So it is approximately 2500, little bit less than 24,500 voltage gain. That is output will be equal to 24,500 times that of input. Second one, power gain. The power gain will be is equal to beta square into output by input. This I formula already we know, that is beta square will be is equal to 49 square, that is approximately 50 square, that is 500, even more it is. Okay, then what is the value we'll get here? Just take the calculator and multiply, we'll get the answer here. So it will be 12,00,500. So much, many times it is increased, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is something like 1.2 into 10 power 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So output power will be is equal to 10 power 6 times that of the input power. So many times. Lakhs. It is increased by some lakhs. That's why in common emitter configuration, amplification, generally we use the transistor as an amplifier in common emitter configuration instead of common collector and common base. That note point we have already taken. Okay, so these are the questions. Like that we can solve many questions. I'll give you some of the questions directly from the NCRT book. So which solution I'll paste to you, you just go through it, that helps you in examination. Yes. Thus, I am pasting for you the three questions. This is the first question that is there in the NCRT book. when you need to go anywhere, that is there in the NCERT book itself. If you have the test book, then you can see it. This is the question. Okay. So, this you can go through your self-study. It's very easy to understand also. Output characteristics as shown in this figure. That is the figure. Calculate the values of beta AC and beta DC when VCE is equal to 10 volts and IC is equal to collector current and collector emitter current is drawn at a constant base current. Okay, definitely here we came to know this will be the output characteristics of a common emitter configuration. This is the output characteristics of a common emitter. Output characteristics of common emitter configuration. Okay, so that I hope you can do it. Solution is also there, then you can try. I'll take another question for you. Yeah, this is the amplifier circuit, common emitter amplification circuit. The question is again based on that only. So maybe it is a acting like a switch or amplifier that you can see here. Varied from 0 point, transassuming network is saturated. Yeah, okay. So that's right. It is used as a switch on state and switch off state. Okay, switch on state and switch off state. That is transistor as a switch. Switch off and switch on state. Okay, then you go through the problem that you can understand very clearly. Any doubt, you can text me. Yeah, so go for another problem. So this problem is again based on so above problem is transistor as a switch, but this problem is transistor as an amplifier that is in the active mode, that is common emitter configuration problem. You go through this. This is the circuit. So even in the NCERT book, there are exercises also there. You can go through the exercises in the NCERT book. So for you, work at home. Complete theory from NCERT book. Second work for you. Complete exercise questions. Exercise questions from NCERT book. Then you take any previous NEET questions book and JE mains. And this is there in only in JEE mains, not in advance. JEE mains solve last at least previous last 5 years to 10 years. If you are available 10 years, so at least 5 years, you will get some idea. Because in the last 5 years, if you see that phase 1, phase 2 are there in each and every phase, there are 8 questions will be there in IIT JEE like this. You will get some collection of questions in the semiconductor physics. Okay, fine. So this is what actually the like in semiconductor physics, one is the diode part, another one will be the transistor part. So the diode part is also finished and transistor part is also finished. In the next session, we will see the digital electronics. So the logic gates will be there. That logic gates are important for us in the examination point of view. That we will study in the next session. It hardly take 1 hour class. 1 hour session is enough. Not more than that. See, one thing is important, always remember here. Whatever you have learned, only just for just fundamentals. Not in-depth analysis we have done here. That is, electronics is a separate branch of physics. So that electronics itself, even in the electronic itself, digital electronics itself is an another branch. So okay, so here we concentrated up to the 12th standard level. What is there in our NCERT book, that exactly we have pointed out that. So the questions, if you see in the NEET and IIT JEE means, they are simply formula based. Or most of the things like giving alpha and calculating beta, like giving input resistance and output resistance, calculating the ratio of the like voltage gain, current gain, power gain, like that. What is the circuit diagram for common emitter configuration, common base configuration? What is the Zener diode? So what is the like forward bias characteristics of a PN junction diode? Like that only they'll ask. Okay, fine. So be careful. Diode part is one. Transistor part is another. Next one will be the logic gates. So that we will go for the next session. So thank you. I'll stop here.